Ethan Carter, I didn't know. But he knew who I was. When the police won't help you and the priests don't believe you, you call on Paul Prospero. You call on me. If you're a kid like Ethan, you're right. Plenty do. Ethan's letter started out just like any other fan mail. But soon there were mentions of things no little boy should know about. There are places that exist that very few people can see. Ethan could have drawn a map. I hadn't entered Red Creek Valley yet, but already I could feel its darkness reaching out for me. Finding Ethan Carter wasn't going to be as easy as knocking on his door. I was too late for that. To find Ethan, I had to figure out what this place was trying to... hide from me.
Ethan, I told you, you can't be here.
But Gramp, I wrote something for you.
That's real nice. Thank you. Just leave it. I'll read it later.
Red Creek Valley seemed like a quiet, ordinary place. I've learned two things in my life. No place is truly quiet, and nowhere is really ordinary. Ethan warned me about that. Warned me not to be fooled by what I saw here. He didn't need to worry. I'd worked dozens of cases, hundreds. This would be my last one. Already I knew that.
Thank you.
Get out of my room, Travis!
Stories, stories, always with the stories.
Get out!
I read the Fangs one. I liked the Beast. At least he gets to leave this goddamn place.
Trains have been through here for a long time. That was part of a pattern. Large pieces of this country were thrown away, doomed to become, and then remain, the worst versions of themselves. Beneath all that rot, dark things grow. I've seen every version of people hurting each other, hurting themselves. And we blame it on compulsion, selfishness, madness. I suppose the idea is, if you name a thing, you can control it. There are things in this world that cannot be named.
What did you do? What did you wake up?
Nothing. I found a room, I walked into it, that's it.
You can feel it, right? Something, something coming from the Vandegrift house.
I can feel it.
You need to talk to your son. He was poking around in the old Vandegrift house again. Said he found some secret room.
Yeah, really? Okay, I will go talk to him.
Travis, leave the boy alone. I see how you've been looking at him.
You don't even know, do you? You have no idea what's going on. You have to help us. It's the only way. It wants Ethan.
You're crazy. You've all gone crazy. Pop, they're getting worse. They keep talking about this thing, this sleeper.
I know. What I don't know is if it's real or not.
It's not my fault. I didn't mean for any of this to happen.
Ethan's family blamed him. Whatever it was he'd accidentally let loose, his family was convinced that hurting him would solve their problems, would soothe their disturbed minds. Whatever haunted the Carters was still here somewhere, in the wind. I've stepped through too many portals, been present in too many worlds simultaneously. Bits and pieces of me stay on the other side, waiting. Whenever I return, I bring parts of those worlds back. Do you know what ghosts are? They're sad, evicted things. Memories without homes. What do the dead have to say? You'd be surprised by how little they know. The dead can't explain what it means to be dead. They walk down stairs that disappear beneath their feet, headed for some bright blade of memory they'll never reach.